there, mate.
Yeah, there's tunas there. I saw the swirls. They're frothing. They're frothing on the bait ball. Go neutral, please. Okay, just up in front of us here, there's some fish swirling, and I saw one jump out of the water, and I'm certain it was a tuna, only it's the middle of winter, and it was too big to be like a skipjack tuna. It was like big. But I don't know what else it could be. So looks by the looks of the way that the birds are kicking around, they're feeding on tiny bait fish, so I've just got a little bait jig. And when we get close enough, I'm gonna fire a cast in there and see what happens. Look, right here, they're really frothing. They're jumping out of the water. Okay, neutral, 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 neutral. That's right over there. Oh, they're right here. Look at this, busting up right here. Right here, Dan. Right here, Dan, look. Oh, yeah, he's got him.
Oh, you're joking.
No, I'm not joking, boy, I got him. Look at them all underneath us. You did idle forward, mate, I might run into the line. Because I've only got a tiny little wee hook on this thing. This is crazy. We just saw some little tunas. It is August, middle of winter. So, okay, just neutral there. I have actually seen bluefin in this close. Unbelievable. Unbelievable that this has happened today. If it's a skippy, it's a hog, eh? It must be down at the bottom by now. Can't go any deeper.
I'm doing some filming myself.
I'll be pretty happy to get a bit of a tuna on board, mate. Bit of fresh sashimi.
Now you can see those beats. That's unmistakably tuna. This is my soft baiting gear and I'm hooked up to a tuna. In New Zealand, like, top water, casting, sight fishing for tuna is something you'd expect to be doing out in the, you know, Central America, you know, Costa Rica or Panama. It's the middle of winter and we're sight fishing for tuna in New Zealand. Oh mate, look at this thing, there's nothing I can do about him. Surely he's not gonna reef me, a tuna. How deep is it here, Murph?
90.
Look at this thing, still going. Still going, it must be at the bottom. That thing is gonna have worn a big hole in its mouth because I've got a soft mouth. I've got a tiny wee hook, so I've got to keep everything real tight. It's boosting up, it's boosting straight up. Oh, is this a bluefin? Holy shit, I've got a bluefin tuna on. I've got a bluefin tuna on.
Beautiful.
Bluefin tuna. Right on the coast of New Zealand.
This is bizarre.
This is unbelievable, mate.
You're kidding.
I'm not even kidding. Can you not tell how animated I am? I'm freaked out.
I'm not sure, because you put on a good show.
Holy shit, Murph. That's a bluefin right there. Or is it the world's biggest skippy? Can't be. It's too big for a skippy. Whatever it is, I really want to catch it. Okay, you ready? Just reach down and slide him into that net. Oh, can he fit in the net? Don't knock the lure out of his mouth. Underneath, go deep, go deep. Holy crap, is that gonna fit in there? I got a sail, boy! Holy shit, look at the size of that thing!
Holy shit!
Look at the size of that as a skipjack tuna, and I seriously thought it was a juvenile bluefin just because I did not think you could catch a skippy like that. Now that is a skippy, middle of winter. Oh my goodness, that is a hog. That is something else, bro, right. Holy smacking duck shit. We're gonna sashimi time this bad boy.
Holy shit, bro.
That is sashimi time. We'll sort this out, I'll get the blood out of him.
Really, really glad I didn't balls that up the net. Imagine if I let it go right at that pivotal moment. I've been like the lowest dog to crawl across the face of the earth. Net guy.
Oh, holy crap, look at this, boys. I mean, look at this.
Rat.
Have you got my little silver jig there? Hold that up next to my little silver jig, and there you go. That's what I caught him on.
That's what he's eating.
And that's what he's eating. So no surprises, we got him first cast. If we take a close look at what this is, uh-oh, It looks like a juvenile sandmar. Wow, this is Tucker. We need bigger tuna tubes. Right, I'll get the blood out of them. You just use that line and then give them a poke in there. Same on the other side. We need to get them cold real quick. Now, of course, this is just getting all the blood out of him, so I'm using a saltwater hose, and I've nicked the artery just above his heart and through the gill, and you can see the blood just pouring out over the back of the boat there. Now, a lot of people are going to tell you skipjack tuna is just bait. Well, I can tell you, if you bleed them out like this and you ice them down, the sashimi is incredible. Just melt in your mouth, and that's what we're going to do with this thing. We're going to see it right through. As soon as this blood's out, which will be about another 30 seconds, it is going to get put in a slurry of ice and salt water. And in about an hour's time, it'll be just beautiful, mate.
Stop it.
Really. Oh, the heart, of course. Let's not forget the heart. Oh, it's got a big heart. Beautiful. Winter skipjack tuna. Oh, honestly, so good. So good.